It was perhaps the most anticipated ruling from the Supreme Court in recent memory. Then the news that the court upheld most of President Barack Obama's health care law, including the mandate that virtually all Americans have health insurance or pay a penalty.
The highest court in the land has now spoken. We will continue to implement this law, and we'll work together to improve on it where we can.
Chief Justice John Roberts joined with the court's four liberal members in making the ruling. About 30 million uninsured people are expected to gain coverage. Another 26 million will remain uninsured. Ultimately, 9 of 10 eligible Americans will be covered. The court did limit a plan to expand Medicaid.
I'm relieved. I guess I was most worried that the Supreme Court would break apart the Affordable Care Act and would just make it muddy and confusing and leave us completely confused about what to expect in the future.
From businesses like this New York bottled tea company to Tea Party activists in Maryland.
And not only do we think socialized medicine is not something we should be participating in, but we are taxed enough already and we do think it needs to be repealed.
Reaction was swift.
Well, I think really what it is a win for the public's health.
Healthcare law expert Joe Teitelbaum calls the Affordable Care Act the most significant law regarding public health in half a century.
What it does is fundamentally realign the way in which individuals interact with their physicians and with their insurers and with their government, for example, and how government relates to states and so on. So it really is a fundamental shift on some levels.
Starting in 2014, almost everyone will have to have insurance or pay a penalty, but there will be subsidies for people who can't afford it. Employers will also face fines if they don't offer insurance. Insurers will no longer be able to deny coverage to people with medical problems or charge them more than others. It will all be paid for by an assortment of tax increases, health industry fees, and Medicare cuts. Matt Friedman, Associated Press.